Hey guys, in this video we're gonna go over Meraki and we're gonna configure an access point, a switch, and two MXs. So this is gonna be the network design. Yeah, so as you could see here, this is gonna be our LAN, like the headquarters, and this is gonna be the branch. Okay. And we're gonna divide this series into multiple videos. So we're gonna start by going over the dashboard. And if you could see like here, the way we've done it is using a /23 subnet for each branch. And we've created like the staff one is 10.200.1.0/25, 128/25, then 1.0.26. And if you could see here from the, in the binary format, this is the last two octet that they do not overlap. Okay, and here I've highlighted in red the subnet, and this is the in black the host port. Okay, so we're gonna have one MX. Like usually, I would prefer if we could, if we have like two HQs. Definitely, we'll have like we don't have a lot of equipment for this now, but like if I had the option, I would do this those MX in high availability, two of them, and I will do two hubs, like one for the LAN. And one for HQ maybe, and one for the DR, or it depends like how your network is set up. Maybe you'll set up one in the POP, one in the DR, or whatever. Anyway, so like if you guys don't already know, like this is just a high level overview of Meraki. So Meraki, everything is managed. Wow, this is a great cloud. So all the control plane is actually managed, or all the management part is managed through the cloud for Meraki. So whenever you want to configure anything on Meraki, you have to do it through the dashboard, and all the equipment should have internet access. And it doesn't have to be on all the VLAN, but like at least one of them, the management one, to be able to reach to the cloud so you could manage your equipment and troubleshoot and so on and so on. It has a lot of flexibility. I love Meraki, especially for branches. The capability that it gives you is amazing. So all right, so do you want to create an account? Just you follow the steps here, specify the region, fill this information, next. It's pretty straightforward. So I've already created this part, and I've added one MX to the, and I forgot the password. 1 second, let me get my password. So whenever you create your account and login, this is the first thing that you get. Highly recommend, since Meraki, everything is managed through the cloud. So like definitely you should do two-factor authentication. This is the first thing you should do. Highly, highly recommended. You could set up your phone and the code will be sent to you, or you could set up the app. Next. This is the phone, and this is setting my on the application. I'm doing it through Duo. You could use whatever application you want, but Duo is the one that I'm using. And here I'm scanning the QR code, verify code. Alright, let's test it out. Alright, I'm in. Alright, so this is the first thing I've done, setting up double factor authentication. The second thing I would do is actually under administrator, and no, that's not what I'm gonna do, is under settings, and here. You could set like expiration date for the password. Like just, you could make it as restricted as you want, but Like for me, I love having double factor authentication and like definitely like strong passwords. And here you could also like if the user should have be on VPN or whatever, you could like limit the IPs. You could enable SAM login if you have Okta or Duo account or whatever. And you could enable SNMP too. So we don't have that enabled, we don't need it because you could also log in account. Then and inactivity, let's make it 30 minutes. All right, so now, so since we've set up like the organization, you could go to inventory to add your devices here. All right, guys, so like this is just a high level overview how to create a Meraki account and how to harden it. So in the next video, we'll go over how to configure time access. Please guys, don't forget to like and subscribe. That will be really helpful. Thank you.